Good evening, sir. My name
Good
is
evening.
Sohil, and my teammates are Shani and Swaraj. And our topic for today is the comparison between an NFA and a DFA. So, an NFA is basically a finite state automaton where we don't know exactly for certain when one state will transition exactly to the next state. In other words, what I mean is that if at least one state exists in an automaton such that upon receiving the same input symbol, it can transition to more than one possible state, then that automaton can be classified as a non-deterministic finite state automaton, or NDFA for short. Now, its counterpart is a DFA or a deterministic finite automaton, and inside a DFA, all the states are arranged in such a way that one single state has the possibility of transitioning to only one possible state upon receiving an input symbol. So, the differences between an NDFA and a DFA are very apparent. So the first difference, as I said, was this very point that a DFA can transition to only one possible output state upon receiving one input symbol, but an NFA can transition to more than one such states. Secondly, a DFA cannot take an empty string as an input, but an NFA can do that. And thirdly, DFA requires more space because since there exists only one-to-one mapping between the transitionable states, so therefore it takes more space to show an automaton based on the DFA perspective. But from an NFA perspective, the automaton always takes a little less space because most of the states are actually combined into less number of states. So, lastly, as for my part, I will like to show the process of conversion between an NFA and a DFA. So, the algorithm in itself is pretty simple. What we do at the first thing that we do is we take the NFA and we prepare the transition table. And in here, I have an example. So inside this example, we clearly see that we have only three states here. The Q2 is the final one. The Q0 is the initial one. So after drawing the transition table, when we start drawing the transition table for the equivalent DFA, the first thing we should do is start with the initial state, and the algorithm goes as follows that we take the first state and then we try to see that which are the next states upon getting the input, and then we take the next state as the next initial state and we include that inside the second row, and we continue this process. Now, for those of the states that can transition to multiple states upon receiving the same input symbol, we include all of those states under the same set. So inside this one example is that in the second row we can clearly see that it says that the state Q0 comma Q1 can transition to Q0 Q1 upon receiving input A, and that's because Q0 by itself can go to the states Q0 and Q1, and Q1 by itself can go to the null state upon receiving input A, and therefore the union of these two is Q0 and Q1, and that's how we get that Q0 Q1 transitions to the Q0 and Q1, means the same state upon receiving the input A. And we can extend the same process for all the other states, and we should continue doing that until we get no more new states, and after that we can clearly see that we have our DFA from there.
So now, whatever my classmates will has explained, we'll see that through an example. Here we have been given a NFA, non-deterministic finite automaton, and we'll see the process how to convert it to a DFA. So the next slide, please, Swaraj. We are now making the transition table from the given NFA. As Q0 is the starting state, initial state. We'll see when the input 0 is given, it according to the diagram in the previous slide, it comes back to itself and also goes to the next state Q1. And when Q0 is given the input 1, it goes to Q1. So under Q0, 0, we have written Q0, it as a set of Q0, 1. And under Q0, 1, we have written Q1. And then there's the final state, that is Q1. When input 0 is given, when input 0 is given, nothing is shown of the state to go elsewhere. So the phi is given to denote that it goes nowhere. And when Q1 is given input 1, it goes to it returns to itself and also Q0 state. So now we'll find out for each state the delta transition. As we know, delta is a transition function, the last of the five tuples that define DFA and also an NFA. So that transition function delta, which is a set of the states that the DFA goes to when it is in state Q and in and an input is received. So the transition function for Q1 is phi from the transition table we can see. And of Q1, when input is 1, it is Q0 comma Q1. So similarly, the transition function for state Q0, it is when the input 0 is given, Q0 comma Q1. We consider it as a single, we are now considering it as a single state, that is a new state, Q0 comma Q1. And for Q0, when the input 1 is given, it is a Q1. Now, as a new state is generated, we can see Q0 comma Q1. We will also have to find the delta transition function of those states. So for Q0 Q1, when the input 0 is given, it is the union function of the delta states of the delta functions of Q0 and Q0 when it is given input 0 and Q1 when it is given input 0. So here we can find out that the result is Q0 comma Q1. Now the next slide, please. And similarly, from the previous one, the delta transition function of Q0 comma Q1 when it is being given the input 1 is that state Q0 comma Q1. So from this we can form a new transition table for the constructed DFA. The first two rows of the transition table are same as the as that of the transition table of NFA. And since we have a new state this time, another row is being added, that is of another final state Q0 comma Q1. Now since Q1 was one of the final was a final state of the given NFA, wherever Q1 will be present, that will be another final state. So Q0 comma Q1 will be another final state of the new DFA. So the transition table of Q0 comma Q1 is when it is given the input 0, it comes Q0 comma Q1, and when it is given the input 1, the result is again Q0 comma Q1, as we have seen from the delta transition function. So looking at this transition table, we can plot the new transition diagram, that is with the new state Q0 comma Q1. And here, as we can see, with double circles, both of the final states are shown, that is Q1 and Q0 Q1. So now for simplifying it, we have renamed Q0 as A, Q1 as B, and the new state Q0 Q1 as C. So simply replacing the names, this is our final DFA state.
Now, in the previous slides, we can see that in NFA to DFA conversion, there are some key main cases of non-determinism in NFA. the first case is transition to a state without consuming any input. And the second is multiple transition on a same input symbol. And another one is no transition on an input symbol. So to convert the NFPA to DFA, as we saw previously in the previous examples, we need to get rid of the non-determinism from NFPA. So we use subset construction method. Using subject construction method to convert NFA to DFA, we involve the column step. For every step, the NFA determine all readable states for every input symbol. And the sets of readable states constitute a single state in the converted DFA. Each state of DFA corresponds to a subset of states in the NFA. Then find readable states for each new DFA step. Like we got in NFA, and until no more new cases can be found. So we can see another example which is complicated than the before one. Here, this is the NFA without lambda transition. So, as we said, the first step is construct transition table showing all reachable states for every state of so the transition table is this. Here we can see that this is the step in Q1 to Q2A delta. We can see that 1, 2, 3, and 4, and 5. These are the QA. And Q2B, these are 4 and 5. In second, we can see that our 3 is there, and in Q2B there is 5, and in QA 3 in 3 there is 5, and in 3 2B there is 2, and in 4 2A there is 5 again, and in 5 there is nothing going outside, so both are 5. These are the transition from state Q to input A, and these are the transition from state Q to input B. So in the second step, we will do the state of states resulting from each transition function constitute a new state. Calculate all the reachable states for every substate in every input. So we'll construct the table, subset construction table. We can see that one to, we will write as it is the first one, and then these are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is a new state, so we are writing this here, and 4 and 5 is also a new state, so we are writing it here. So from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, step 3 is repeat the process until no new states are reachable. So again 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then one B is 2, 3, and 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. So we again a new step, so we are writing five in A and five in B. The last one is and two. Now move new states ahead. Go up here when there are no more states. From the second section, we have Like that, we found the kind of count to from A and right. So, next part is going to be signing.
And so these are five MCQs
Yeah,
on
you carry
the
on.
same topic.
It is, but yeah, you carry on. Your voice is.
Swaraj, can you change the slide?
Yeah, when you answer it, it is, I think, 2 to the power 8 should be the answer, no? It just, yeah, you explain and answer, any one of you. Any one of you, please explain and answer. Thank you. Thank you. I think it is done.
Hello.
Yeah,
the second question is consider the DFA given. Which of the following are false? So this is the diagram and the complement L of A is context P. And L of A is equal to L bracket 11 into 11 plus 0. 0 plus 1 into 0 into 1. For the language accepted by A is minimal DFA. A accepts all strings over 0, 1 of length at least 2. Here is we can say that only the for language for this given picture, only the for the language accepted by A. A is minimal DFA and A accepts all strings over 0 and 1 of length at least 2. These two are correct. In the second question, we can see that let N be the NFA with N states, let K be the number of states of a minimal DFA which is equivalent to N. Which of the following is necessarily true? So the options are K greater than equal to 2 to the power N. K greater than equal to n, k less than equal to n square, and k less than equal to 2 to the power. So here we can clearly see that it is k less than equal to 2 to the power n. The next question is in this given DFA, it accepts the strings of all over 0, comma a that begins with either 0, comma 0 or 1, ends with 0, ends with 0, 0. And contains the substring 00. So here we can see that it will accept the string 00 that will they have contains substring 00. So correct answer is ends with 00. Thank you for
thank
everything.
You.
Thank
Very
you,
good.
SRC sir.
Thank you.